one. We are a 5-day working manufacturing company. We need to pay for 5 days or 6 days for the contract workers. So that is the question. Again, whether it is 5 days or 6 days, it doesn't make any difference, right? The working, the quantum to be determined. Again, that the same formula which you will use during the normal period, you may have to use the same for the lockdown period also. I think there is absolutely no difference. Again, the responsibility is on the principal employer to pay the consideration, and the liability is on the contractor to pay the wages to his workers in turn. That is the idea, right? Whether it is 5 days or 6 days, it doesn't make any difference. Yeah, whatever formula you will use during the normal period, I think the same formula you may have to use here also. Yeah. Go on. Will the ITES company providing financial and accounting services to foreign countries be considered essential services? It is not actually, it cannot be considered as essential service, because when we say essential, I think the service should go to the public at large, right? Or very much connected to that. So like vegetables, milk, maybe the fuel, petrol or diesel, whatever it is, right? So or medicines. These are all considered as the essential commodities or the essential services, right? So when you say providing financial and accounting services to foreign countries, I think it is limited to your own cost, right? So it cannot be considered as the essential services as this term is meant by the guidelines, right? It is not so. Yes, for your company it may be essential, right? But again, that is not the idea. When you say essential, it is maybe media. It is essential because information has to flow every now and then. So it is essential service. So I think clearly the declaration is there. What are all the essential services under the central government, under the state governments, under the maybe the private and private industrial establishments and the commercial establishments. It is very clear, right? But this will not be considered as essential service. But in case, if you have, say, in your company, if you have 500 employees, and if you are asking almost all of them to work from home, and it is also assume it is feasible, but for maybe for around 475 to 450, 480 people to operate from their homes, respective homes, if you want the rest 10 to 20 people to come to your office, so for maintenance, making some other support for the other people to operate from home, then I think that is very genuine. You can make a request to the authority concerned. Definitely, they are doing it. So you may have to meet them, give them the written request, clearly mentioning the purpose. They are, of course, allowing that. But they will only check whether the number can be minimized, right? Because the idea is people should not come out, right? That is the main purpose. Yeah, move on. What if a worker in a factory willingly applies for leave during lockdown? I think we discussed on this also. If somebody who is asked to work from home, he has also agreed, but for some reason he is not working, and generally he is applying for leave, right? You can accept that, right? But have the records proper, because tomorrow if somebody questions, you should be in a position to substantiate your case, right? Yeah. Otherwise, technically, yes, you can accept. Can the probationers, trainees be relieved during lockdown period? No. Again, I think nomenclature or the class of workers will make no difference here, whether it is permanent employees or probationers or temporary employees or fixed term employees or trainees or contract workers, casual workers or interested migrant workmen, whoever is in your service as on 24th March, you may have to maybe extend them, provide them opportunity to serve for the lockdown period also. You may have to pay them for that period also, right? Even apprentices, under the Apprentices Act, that is the guideline, right? Yeah.